Hi everyone, my name is Ian Van Tuyl and we're standing on a 2014 Jeanneau 53. This particular vessel just arrived about 2 weeks ago, was commissioned and put in the water. Starting out up front, you're going to notice we have this white gearbox here. This is a electric furler. This is a pro furler unit. This furler unit is controlled in the cockpit by a double switch allowing you to furl and unfurl your head sail, really giving you that peace of mind to operate this vessel really shorthanded or single-handed. One thing about the 2014 model is you have much higher lifelines. They actually hit you right here in the upper thigh, giving you a good support too. Last year's model, they were down a little bit lower, so they decided to raise those up for safety. As you can see here, we have really nice wide decks that I can walk on, nice forward deck area. Typically, a lot of my clients, what they'll do is they'll put a forward sun pan here with a head bolster, and it creates this a big lounge area, really nice element of the boat to be on. As we walk back aft, you're going to notice one thing that Jeanneau does differently than most manufacturers is they have these really high-end chalk cleats here. This gives you the proper pull on your cleat, so the cleat itself doesn't get the pull directly sideways. It gets a lateral pull, pulling it down to your cleat, a really nice feature. And then leading off of this is a stainless steel cap rail. So all of these small things really add up, but something to really look at when you're comparing this vessel against something else. As you can see, as we come back here to the aft, it's done throughout three places on the vessel. It's a continuous tow rail besides these opening chocks, so it's a really nice addition and it really finishes out quite nice. The transom of this vessel is quite unique. We have a really nice three-step area here. We have the swim ladder that folds down out into the water, and then this is a small garage here that lifts up. Now in this particular 2014, we brought this in with air and gen, and so this is a dedicated locker back here that's in a full soundproof case, the generator, and then it also has extra sound absorption back here, and then it collapses this off. So you have a really nice dedicated area for the generator. It's actually away from the master cabin, so all of that noise, if you're running it, is the furthest place away from the master cabin. This is also used as a dedicated life raft storage locker here, or you can have all your goodies in it. We have a swim step shower on the back of the vessel. So this is a hot and cold swim step shower. Nice high-end faucet here, none of the plastic things that tend to break. Shore power inlet, LED stern light, and then we have a nice little lockdown right here that locks the swim ladder into place. So when this is locked down, this becomes another grab handle as you walk up into the vessel. So dual helms, really nice layout. One thing that I want you to take a look at is when you're in the cockpit here, you're going to notice that they have wheel wells that give you really good support. So when, depending on what heel I'm at, regardless, I have areas to brace myself up against. You're going to notice that the side seats are also angled. So if you're up on a heel up on the high side, this is giving you really good flat ground to base yourself off of to get good control over the helm. You're also going to notice the seats have angles to it. There's dedicated areas for draining, so they've thought of all of this. Going into that life raft locker that I told you about, this is access into it from the cockpit here as well. So a nice little wood grate here. Centrally located, this is the latest Raymarine hybrid touchscreen GPS plotter. So this is a new addition for this 2014 model year. They have the nice rubber cover on this, and it's all touchscreen. At the port helm here, you're going to see that we have really nice instrumentation. We have the bow thruster controller. This is the latest control module head unit here. This operates our bow thruster. Just above this is our windlass chain counter, our Raymarine multi-repeater autopilot function, and we also have a repeater at the starboard helm as well too. Your throttle control, and then below this is our RPM gauge. So it's a new retro style Yanmar RPM gauge. We're going to also have two-speed Harkin electric winches, and then this set of gauges controls our electric head sail furler. So you can see what I was talking about. For being right here at the helm, you can control your head sail and also have really good function of your sheets at both helms, so quite nice. This is a remarkable cockpit. This particular cockpit Can literally house up to 14 guests on board very comfortably. It's a three-part cockpit. So you have your first part is behind the helms, second around the cockpit table, and then the third part is just underneath where a Dodger would go. Really nice area, just an enormous cockpit for this size of a vessel. Also found at the base of the companionway, steps here, is a dedicated area for all of your sheets and halyards. So instead of having them up here, like we are showing it right now today, all of these will wrap down here and stow really nice and neat. The companionway hatch is also something to look at. You can see really nice, easy function. It locks into place and then slides down there. So there's none of this pulling your hatch covers out or having doors bifocal out. Really nice elements when you come up to here. We also have an electric cabin top winch. And then you're going to see that all of our halyards and sheets are led back into the cockpit. A nice large Harken Traveler. These are all Harken blocks. Jeanneau uses nothing but the best from its running rigging, standing rigging, and all of the elements that they use for the Travelers, winches, and blocks. These are high load Harken blocks, a really nice, a great addition. They have the Technique full lay sails. In Europe, these are probably one of the highest end sails that you can buy without kind of going into that custom element. So really nice high-end sails. They're a radial type of sail and phenomenal for the Dacron. As we walk up forward, you can see this area that I was kind of talking about earlier where you can put a nice big sun pad here, different areas to stage and lay out in. And then we have a full dedicated a sail locker. You can have this have the option of a crew quarters, but this particular sail locker is quite large and you can use this for various amount of things. Located above this is our isolated anchor locker. This particular locker is quite large. We have about 300 foot of road and about 100 foot of chain on this with plenty of room to spare. Double bow rollers, and then there's also a tack attachment point right here between the two bow rollers. As we walk back aft, you're gonna see the styling and the look that Philippe Briand has developed into this particular model. Large overhead windows that just let a lot of natural light flood the salon. Lots of opening hatches to get great ventilation and a really nice ease when walking around the deck from all the steps that allow you to gracefully enter the cockpit. Coming down below the vessel, we have four steps that bring you right into the vessel. Now, the 2014 encompasses a couple of different element changes from exterior and then the interior. Interior, you're going to see this white corian striping. They've also incorporated leather on the top areas here to really bring out a lot of natural light. We have the new white oak floors with the dark brown striping. Really sets it off. It is that cross between contemporary European but also traditional styling too. So the table itself, I've gone into detail, I did a video on this. This table is quite unique. So as you can see, there's a little pull pin here. This pull pin allows the table to come and slide in closer to me. So if I'm eating dinner, it also has two leaves that open up on both sides. And then with a little pull from the lock, slides back into position. I'm gonna move these chairs out of the way a little. And then located right underneath the air conditioning controller is a up and down switch. The switch itself lowers the table down and it turns this into a really nice coffee table. So it just kind of takes this particular element that's always in one traditional spot, lowers it down and just makes a really nice coffee table. You can even put your feet up if you so desire, but transforms this area quite nicely. With the push of a button, it raises right back up. And you can have this at any designated height that you want. So for now, we're just going to leave it at this height, tuck our chairs back in, and go on. Now, the bulkhead itself is set up really nicely. So if you so desire to have televisions on board, I would recommend, you know, putting a TV here. Otherwise, a really nice piece of artwork, and then a TV on this side, if you so desire. We have the Bose Cube speakers. This is a Pioneer headset. This is a stereo CD DVD player. And we have a built-in subwoofer as well, too. So follow me into the forward master, and I can kind of tell you some changes they've done here. The door itself for the hanging locker, they've wrapped this in leather to kind of bring out some color combinations. We have that Corian striping that they've carried on through. They've also brought white leather through here, the darker leather on the sides. And these are really high-end, you know, custom mattresses that come from the factory. So you can see just how thick these are. And then underneath this is batten, so that lets the mattresses breathe. So when you're in an environment that has a lot of humidity or, you know, changing temperatures, it's always really nice to let that mattress breathe. They've also wrapped this in white leather. And we have some really nice areas, you know, that are kind of hidden inside the vessel that you can get access to. That's where, if you wanted a dedicated safe, that's where that would be located. Nice stainless steel trim here. As we walk into its private head, another thing that they've done differently is they brought white lacquered cabinetry into the doors. They've also changed the faucets. So it used to have just your traditional faucet. So now we have more of that European out-of-the-wall type of faucet. They've redesigned the sink bowl a little bit. And then you have a really nice bifocaling shower divider that just locks into place like so, keeping it really simple and easy, and then stows back underway just like so. Lots of storage found throughout. So all of these overhead cabinets open. Underneath the bed, there is a huge drawer that pulls out. All of the cabinets have self-closing hinges on them. And they've really just done a phenomenal job. Look at the size of this hanging locker. We have bedding and stuff in here, but you can just see this is quite large and very, very deep. Walking back through the salon, you know, we have no lights on. This is just flooded with all the natural light. So quite beautiful. Two staterooms aft. Each aft cabin has a queen-size berth. They have a really nice area here. We have air conditioning and heating controls in this aft cabin. Nice hanging locker, storage and drawers found throughout. And then you have your own private access into the head and shower. From the cabin itself, and then also the second door from the salon. And this is duplicated on the opposite side as well, just aft of the galley. The galley is quite unique. What they've done here is a three burner stove and oven, an overhead stainless steel vent that vents the exhaust overboard. We have a nice opening cabinet here with a dedicated microwave, lots of storage found throughout. We have a top loading and side loading refrigerator. This is another model change for 2014. They've actually put, you know, grates in here so you can pull out and get easier access to your refrigerator. There's a small freezer compartment built in here, and then you also have a full dedicated freezer under here. So really, really nice. Well done. Double stainless steel sinks. This is really nice Corian countertops that they use here. The nice faucet, and then this right here with the foot pump gives up the galley here. Once again, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you found this helpful and informative. If you have any questions, concerns, or want more information on the Jeanneau product, please feel free to contact me at any time, day or night. Thanks again, and I look forward to hearing from you.